We the Ambazonia, special loyalty. Presence to a savior who granted us the freedom. Allegiance to the hero who fought along the diablo.
Glory will rise and never to fall. Hearing a nation flowing with milk and honey. Glory, glory, glory to the Father for making you a nation, a joy forevermore. Ambazonia, land of freedom, you shall live in plenty meeting our needs. And your children shall be like the stars above. The Most High God be the watchman of this nation. Ambazonia, land of freedom, you shall live in plenty, meeting our needs. And your children shall be like the stars above. The Most High God be the watchman of this nation.
Happy Monday. Today's Monday, October 26, 2020. We're going to have a dandy show today. George Prokop is here. Good to see you, George. Cliff will interest her. You can see on the screen there. Cliff Krieger's here. Jim Peters is here. Waiting on Fru. Slide in. And then I'm John McDonough. We're going to have the national anthem coming up here. So I got to hit this button with the national anthem.
And now here to perform the American National Anthem, please welcome our Galaxy Social Night Contest winner, the tiny but mighty 7-year-old singer from Los Angeles, Malaya Emma Chandragwijaya.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proud? Gleaming, whose bright stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. Oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
Everyone, Cliff Krieger here. It's a City Life show on Monday, the 26th of October. I'm zooming in the studio. We have George Prokop and John McDonough, and also on Zoom we have Jim Peters, and we have Fru and Ken Bang, who would. In sliding in. Back to Fru. So apparently there's a police brutality going on and unrest, and 56 people dying, and they're not even blaming the Boko Haram for it. They're saying the government. Is there any chance of that unrest spreading next door to Ambazonia?
That you brought about Nigeria. I think the most important thing that we need to understand is the president of Nigeria addressed the nation, and he disbanded that opportunity to bring problems into the country. He also called on neighboring countries and the international community not to rush to judgment and draw their own conclusions. So, listening to the president speak in that capacity and promise that they have received all the grievances, they have accepted all the grievances that the students, that the young people presented to the government. And they are taking action. The immediate one was to disband that notorious police wing. He did that, and that he was going to walk with the protesters to see that, to make to change the system for better.
Well, that is a good thing. I'm happy to hear you report that to us. So it looks like it's getting under control, or was it not really?
Cliff, I got a text from somebody from another country. I'll tell you the guy's name in a second. This guy's first name is Christmas. That ring a bell to you, Fru? Guy's first name is Christmas?
I should know the guy. Read what he says. Christmas Ebini?
It's terrible.
Is it Christmas Ebini?
Yeah.
Ebini.
Yep. Yeah. And person who's telling me, that wrote me like a very long text here, and it's pretty sad how the military went into a school and killed a bunch of kids.
It was really bloody Saturday. Saturday, kids were in the classroom. The Cameroon army, these guys, came in. I mean, you need to see the rampage, the blood that they killed these kids in classroom. I mean, the images were horrific. That it was really a bloody black Saturday.
Warning. The following video contains graphic images of torture and summary executions in the southern Cameroons, West Africa. Accordingly, viewer discretion is advised.
This show's recorded, and somehow, Fru has some kind of magic where he gets it on Cameroon TV, so the Cameroon government watches this. It's rebroadcast, somehow, through magic, all over the world, because I have got phone calls from France, Spain, Cameroon, I got the United States, all over the United States. So there's good coverage of this particular issue through this program, and we need to put this out there because the people, the government of Cameroon watches the show. I couldn't believe it, but they do. And to put this in front of them, and for the people in France to see it, that France is rumored to be training these people to kill their own, the folks in Cameroon, especially the folks in the Cameroon army, that sooner or later, someone's going to get involved with this and stop this wrongdoing. These videos prove that you kill people.
Warning. The following video contains graphic images of torture and summary execution in the southern Cameroons, West Africa. Accordingly, viewer discretion is advised.
So John brought up the school massacre, and I got the link to the video. YouTube spiked. Is this just some rogue outfit in Ambazonia, I think it's just more policy?
Fru wanted me to talk about this. Fru, can we talk about what happened briefly in Cameroon? How I got a text from one of Fru's friends, and I'm not going to say the guy's name because.
John. The guy is outside. These are your audience that are watching you from all over the world.
I understand, but does this guy live in Cameroon? Does he have any relatives in Cameroon?
No, he's not in Cameroon. He's here. That's one of them. He's in Washington. I have people who watch your program all over the world.
Okay, well, this guy, Christmas, he sent me, his real name's Christmas. What a cool name to have, Christmas.
Yeah, that's Dr. Christmas Ebini.
I don't care if he's a doctor. The best thing that happened to him is mother named him Christmas. Everybody loves Christmas. People don't
don't love the doctor so much, but they love Christmas. So Christmas sent me a text detailing how the government of Cameroon, their soldiers, got into an unmarked van. They hopped in a Toyota Senia, something like that. Toyota van, drove it up to towards the school, clandestinely got out of the van with their automatic weapon, and went into a school and proceeded to kill all the children in the school. And maybe they didn't kill all the kiddos. Even if they killed one kiddo, that's too many. But they killed, I'm hearing, 54 kids. Their military weapons. These troops were trained by Benny Netanyahu from Israel. They were trained by him. The United States.
Not personally.
Hey, you want to tell the story, Cliff? The United States, President Trump, shipped them these guns. Shipped them the gun. Right now, America is way too busy battling between the red coats and the blue coats, Democrats, Republicans. Benny Netanyahu, the guy who runs Israel, just been reelected, runs a fantastic country. In there, beautiful, beautiful place. If you have a chance to visit Israel, please do. You're going to have a great time. If you email him and tell him what happened, you might be able to. He's a very interesting guy. He just might put his finger on that and take care of it in a way that we have not been able to do it. Even though we've written Elizabeth Warren, we've written Ed Markey, written Lori Trahan, we've written President Trump. And the only thing that's going to stop is you got to hit him in the wallet. If you hit him in the wallet, France, anybody who speaks French, you can write the guy who runs France, but I don't speak French. This has got to stop. We got to stop killing little kiddos that are going to school. Why would the government do such a thing? I don't have time for questions. This has got to stop. Mind the why. There's no reason in the world why you should kill an 8-year-old kiddo. There's no reason in the world. We're paying for it with our taxes. We're buying them guns. Benny Netanyahu, guy who runs Israel, is training these people, and I don't think these guys know what's actually happening. Fru, do you want to sum it up? And then we're going to go back to Cliff.
Yes, John. I actually sent you one of the clips. You can show it and just see the classroom, how bloody it is. I sent it to you by email. But Dr. Chris Ebini is really a good patriot, and he has his ear on actually what is going on the ground. And it so happened that he comes from that area and he knows that school very well. What he is explaining is what I had mentioned earlier, that the government comes in civilian clothes because their intention is to label the Ambazonia Defense Group that have stood up to them for these 4 years, which miraculously they did not foresee it coming, to get the sympathy of the international community. The international community knows more than what the vicious dogs in Cameroon are doing. So they come up with this plot to massacre these students. And these are the very people who have been pushing that schools should resume in times of war. This was their plan, so that they can cause this massacre. So that, and blame the Ambazonians, and that is what they did. They came in civilians when kids were in class on motorbike, jump in, enter the classroom, spray bullets, and jump out. And the government truck was waiting for them at the corner street up a little bit further down the street. These are eyewitnesses are narrating this, calling from ground zero, that, you know, this is not the Ambazonia. And leave a few minutes after that disaster, the army came in, and the army, you could see, the army, the first thing that they did, went on public and said that these are the Ambazonia Defense Group that have done this. What does Ambazonia have to gain by killing their own in their own territory? So that is what Comrade Christmas Ebini is actually communicating. I didn't write that email. That's what, if you see people writing from all over, they watch your show. All day, even on Ground Zero, John has received comments from all over the world. So City Life Show is not just local. It's, as I mentioned, it's the CNN and Fox News, and provide a fair and balanced picture of what really is going on in Cameroon. While the bigger networks, I don't know, maybe they are waiting for so many people to die before they can bring it up, protecting and buying them. Mr. Bia has very deep pockets, and that is what he has done around the world to buy for lobbies.
Yes, that's a problem. Getting the word out is hard, very hard. Maybe we'll have more information next week.
Yes, I'll bring it.
I worry about, as I mentioned earlier, I worry about press not doing its job. I worry about big tech, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, all those people pressing the truth.
What this was, what the thing is, the government of the Francophone government have been humiliated because this is a military that is trained by Israel, supported by the U.S. until President Obama and President Trump, they withdrew the support. It is there.
Frodo, did you say they're trained by Israel?
Huh?
They're trained by Israel?
The B, when you see the military, B-I-R, that's Brigade d'Intervention Rapide, they're trained by Israel, yes. And then also you see France is out there backing them with the ammunition, the capital, and also with the international diplomacy at the Security Council.
Because you can say whatever you want, but Netanyahu is not going to tolerate people that he trained massacring in children in schools. If you can,
that is why it's good that this information comes out. It's good that this information comes out. But what I was getting at is people on the ground, would you believe that in a school like that, the military was nowhere to be found? Immediately after the bloody massacre, the military came in and then they were blaming the Ambazonian separatists. And then eyewitness said that these guys came in civilian clothing. There were six of them that came in on motorbike. Immediately they caused this atrocity. They ran towards the junction. There was a military truck there and picked them away. And why would you ask, can you really understand this? The government has been fighting this for 4 years, four good years. And according to the government, they thought that within 3 months maximum, they were going to crush the Ambazonian spirit and claim victory. Because they first started by taking all farm tools or disarming the whole area. But they have not succeeded. So now they are going and causing a lot of... This is you remember the Valentine massacre? This is now... They push for schools resumption because they wanted to do this so that they can appeal to the international community to label the Ambazonian Defense Group as terrorists. And also, since most of us are mostly in this country, and then the political muscle that we are building here, the senators, even the president, everyone is saying it and supporting us, that they could, and they have also hired so many lobbies here on the ground, work for them. So if they tag the Ambazonian as terrorists, then they will have to win. That is the strategy that is happening. And then innocent kids, ranging from 10 to 15, are slaughtered in cold blood. You see the other one, the head was blown off in the classroom. Just imagine those kids who were with them in the classroom and lived through that experience. Will they ever recover? Will their parents ever recover? Will the community ever recover? Would Ambazonia ever recover? Their intention is to intimidate and spread fear. That is, if you look what happens across all French countries, there is no peaceful demonstration like what happened in Nigeria. They come with the iron fist and crush. They don't even care. And France is behind doing that, encouraging that. They have done that in Togo. They have done that in Gabon. They have done that in Central Africa. They are still doing it there. It is very, very passionate for me to see. I mean, I am a parent. You know, you look at those images. YouTube had the reason to block it because Cliff and me are awful. I've never seen something like that. A student, a child, 10 years old in a class, all of a sudden you see the head is blown, and then you see blood spilling on other children, all of them ducking on down on under their stools and screaming.
The massacre was horrible. YouTube blocking the film. I don't mind them putting a warning up. We have to get information out about things that are going on in this world. Otherwise, we don't have an informed voting public. It's the job of the news to inform us. That's why they get the protection under the First Amendment. I think YouTube and Twitter and Facebook blocking this stuff is just wrong. It's a death knell for democracy.
Most of you know this more than I, that a retreating army is a desperate one, and they will destroy everything on their path. That is what French Cameroon is doing now. By day, they are military. They wear the military uniform. Some of them disguise like priests. They disguise like peddlers. And at night, they to go and do the atrocities. They are the very first ones to go on the air and say the Ambazonian fighters did. Why? I mean, just imagine, Ambazonian Defense Force, they didn't start this war. They are fighting to protect their people. And the people who are being massacred are their brothers, are their sisters, are their sons, are their mothers, are their parents. What do they really have to gain? Come in their own neighborhood and kill their brothers or siblings, whom they would be the very one to carry and bury. Is that really something that, will it take a scientist to put two and two together and see who is behind this? I don't think, no. It's just common sense.
Well, I agree. John, did you want to say something? I had that look.
This is just this whole story about weaponry, military weaponry used to walk into any school globally and just to kill all the students. Unbelievable. The UN is going to do nothing about this. Elizabeth Warren is going to do nothing about this. President Trump's going to do nothing about this. It's election season. Benny Netanyahu, he's already in place, won re-election. So if we could all look up Benny Netanyahu, he's the guy who runs Israel. Send him an email and tell him about this incident, and perhaps he'll do an investigation. And there's one country you don't fool around with. That's Israel. If Israel trained these killers, they killed these children. Netanyahu, if we can get him interested, we'll go after them. We'll go after them and put a stop to it. That's just my own personal opinion. Cliff, what do you think of Netanyahu?
I like Netanyahu. I think he understands doing the right thing. And I think that we have to get the information now. How many of our fellow Lowellians know anything about this? They know what's going on. 56 people killed by police out of control in Nigeria. Who knows about these?
All the SARS, right? S-A-R-S? Is that what they're called? Fru?
Yeah. John, I think you and Cliff, you've put your finger on the button. Because with me, the thing is, we always say that if you come to my village, Bamenda, I cannot just walk to the palace and see the phone. Someone has to lead you to the palace. So with this, what I'm just doing is, I think you and Cliff are on the same level, and that is what we, if I bring those images, mostly, John, you guys have seen this more than any, you are more aware of the crisis more than Ambazonians. I could see the passion, how this weighs on you and how you talk about it. Yes, it's only people like you who can contact someone, the Prime Minister of Israel, Excellency Netanyahu, to be able to say, this is happening. Are you really aware that your forces are training these people? Because you stand a better chance to lead my cry and my pain and call Elizabeth Warren. Call Senator Markey, call these other people, call the president, the other senators, and then lead me to see them. Because as well as if you were to come to Bamenda, you remember, John, you were at City Hall. When,
yep.
when His Royal Highness came here, I was the one who brought him to the City Hall. So, so in this case, I'm also appealing that you people have just been our brothers and advocating the voice of the voiceless for these people who are being massacred by this monstrous monster in Cameroon. They have done this to us for more than 50 years, and they have tried to cover it down to technology. Images can just come from home and you will see them live. That is the greatest threat to all these tyrants in the third world. This technology that we have bypassed them, the internet, they are unable to manage. You remember more than three months, Cameroon entered the Guinness record for suspending internet in the whole English area. 4 months, because they didn't want the whole world to know what was going on. And just guess what? How many lives were lost when the lights were turned off?
Well, that's a problem. And there's a lot of that going on in the world. And it's only when we get the news that we actually know about it.
Well, this is if you remember what happened in Rwanda, it was the same thing. You know, they were suppressing everything, and then when it broke out, the whole world responded because it was unbelievable that all those atrocities were going on, and people weren't paying attention. So it's the same thing here. At some point, this will explode even greater than it is now. I mean, you can see the articles on BBC if you wanted to look and find them. I mean, it's worldwide. It's just, to your point, Cliff, the fact that, you know, things are being blocked, then you suppress people from knowing the right information.
George, thank you for bringing the case of Rwanda. And guess who was in Rwanda? It was the French. And you remember, they engineered this intertribal war. That is what they do. They pitch the locals together. They supply them arms and to massacre them so that they want you to submit. George understand, and everyone understand, if Africa is not available, France will be one of the third world nation in the world. If you look in the history of Europe and in the history of warfare in Europe, France is what it is because of the Africans. And if France is a member of the Security Council, not because it did anything during the World Wars, but because the Africans fought for France. And you remember when they were coming into Paris, the Africans who fought and defended France, coming into Paris, France removed the Africans and put the French white people ahead. And in the end, the Africans who fought to liberate France, France put them in a concentration camp. When they asked for their compensation, what did they do? They massacred them. They killed all of them. There's a movie. That's life. So when you come to Africa and to Rwanda, Rwanda was a French country. Almost 800,000 to a million people were floating the rivers in Rwanda. Even I recall President Clinton made that famous statement and said, never, never again. And almost 25 years now, Rwanda is English speaking. And Rwanda is a role model in Africa. Can you imagine? Can you really imagine? Ambazonia is like little Kuwait, even by far richer than Kuwait. Because we have the natural resources, we have the forests, we have oil, we have everything. And if we part our ways, things will start falling apart on French hegemony in Africa. And that is where the ice is.
Oh, thank you, Fru. We have to be aware about what's going on in the world, because we can be without knowing it's part of the problem.
Yes.
Did anybody watch the debate between the president and Vice President Biden?
Yes.
The president at one point said to moderator, reporter Kristen Welker, I respect your handling of this. I think he was happier with her than he was with Chris Wallace. Professor Elizabeth Schmidt says it was patronizing and cringeworthy for the president to make a complimentary comment to Kristen Welker. I thought that was nice of the president to do that. Was he being patronizing? Was he talking down to her because she was a woman, not a man?
I didn't take it that way, Cliff, but there were times when I was bored, so that might have been one of those times I was bored.
It could also be the fact that people feel that there is a history there, like for instance his interview with Leslie Stahl and how he responded to her. But I would say that with the Kristen Welker interview, again, I took it with a grain of salt, so if I am wrong, I apologize, but I didn't take it the way as patronizing. The reason why I say that is because his comments might be based on the fact that on Twitter he was already criticizing her before the debates, before she was moderating the debates, days before. So the fact that maybe she did a better job is probably why he responded to that. That's just my guess. I don't know.
The only thing I can say is if I am the one being interviewed, I think I leave the audience and those who are watching to pass judgment. I should not stand there and compliment my interviewer. Is it that I'm just trying to make him favor to be soft to me? What am I trying to show up there to make her feel good, to treat me not as harsh as the other previous person did, or probably the compliment from the text messages that I had done said shape my image. Really, I really take that with a grain of salt, whether that was genuine or that was just, you see.
So, George, you got any quick last-minute thing you want to say?
We got a few seconds left. Yeah, it's always lively with you guys, I would say. So I enjoy these discussions.
Bye, kids. See you tomorrow. Thanks, guys.
Bye-bye.
Take care.
Hello, my brothers and sisters. My heart is full of sadness after watching what happened in Kumba yesterday, Bloody Saturday. I come to you with a very heavy heart, and I am pleading and begging all our leaders in the diaspora to keep aside your differences and come together like one so that we can face this terrible enemy that is killing us. La République has failed, and they are a retreating army. A retreating army is the most reckless, inhuman that you can think of. Brothers and sisters, if you are seeing these images, these bloody images, like I do, please let us keep our differences and come together to fight and liberate our people who are suffering on the ground. These children deserve more. What did they do to deserve this kind of atrocity? What did they do? What crimes have they committed? This is cold-blooded murderers who have inflicted this. I ask the international communities to really think how they can allow this to continue. And for our brothers who call themselves Francophones, I wonder, when you see these images, do you have a heart? Look at your daughter, your son, your nephew, your niece, who's with you. Look at them in the eye, and you can really feel the pain of the parents, the other traumatized students. We have to do something. Let us rise up. This is inhuman. This is not African. Mes chers camarades, les Camerounais, francophones, c'est avec un cœur très lourd, très lourd. Je me demande si nous sommes les animaux, les bêtes ou bien les humains. Ce qui s'est passé dans la salle de classe à Kumba, c'est terrible, c'est terrible. Demandez-vous si vos enfants, si c'était vos enfants, qu'est-ce que vous allez faire? Qu'est-ce que vous allez faire? Qu'est-ce qu'ils ont, quel crime ont-ils commis pour être massacrés par l'armée camerounaise? L'armée camerounaise est désespérée. Vraiment, ils ont été humiliés par nous, les Ambazonis. Ils veulent semer le désordre entre nous. Ils ne réussiront plus. Ils ne réussiront pas. Mes frères, levez-vous, soulevez-vous et luttez contre le crime de M. Biya. À bon entendeur, salut.
Hail, hail, hail this land of glory. We Ambazonia.